My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, we are still talking about the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And as we mentioned before, that the love of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam includes two aspects: his love for others and the love of others for him. And we went over the first aspect, which is his love for others, and today we'll go over the second aspect, the love of others for the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So loving the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of basics of iman, faith, it's a condition of iman. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, قُلْ إِنْ كَانَ آبَاؤُكُمْ وَأَبْنَاؤُكُمْ وَإِخْوَانُكُمْ وَأَزْوَاجُكُمْ وَعَشِيرَتُكُمْ وَأَمْوَالٌ اقْتَرَفْتُمُوهَا وَتِجَارَةٌ تَخْشَوْنَ كَسَادَهَا وَمَسَاكِنُ تَرْضَوْنَهَا أَحَبَّ إِلَيْكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ وَجِهَادٍ فِي سَبِيلِهِ فَتَرَبَّصُوا حَتَّى يَأْتِيَ اللَّهُ بِأَمْرِهِ. Say, if your fathers, your sons, your brothers, your spouses and mates, your relatives, wealth which you have gained, trade for which you fear that there is will be no sale, and houses and homes with which you are pleased, are more beloved to you than Allah and His Messenger, and striving in His way, then wait until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring about His decision and His command to pass. Al-Imam al-Qurtubi rahimahullah said, commenting on this ayah is evidence that loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger is obligatory, and that this love must take priority over everything else. This is a ruling on which there is no difference among the scholars. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said in the Quran, An-Nabiyyu awla bil mu'minina min anfusihim. The Prophet is closer and more worthy of the believers than themselves. And this ayah shows that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has a higher claim on the believers than they have on themselves, that he is more important and more beloved to them than anyone else, including their own selves. And Sahl ibn Sa'd rahimahullah said, "Man lam yara ولاية الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم أو ولاية الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم في جميع الأحوال لا يذوق حلاوة سنته، لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من نفسه. Whoever doesn't feel that the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم has full rights of command over him at all times will never taste the sweetness of following the sunnah. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, none of you will be a true believer until I am more beloved to him than himself. And this is a famous hadith and narration, as it was narrated that Abdullah ibn Hisham said, كنا مع النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو آخذ بيد عمر بن الخطاب فقال له عمر يا رسول الله لأنت أحب إلي من كل شيء إلا من نفسي. Abdullah ibn Hisham said, we have been with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he was holding the hand of Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu. And Umar said to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Messenger of Allah, you are more beloved to me than everything except my own self. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to Umar, لا والذي نفسي بيده حتى أكون أحب إليك من نفسك. No, by the one in whose hand is my soul, not until I am more beloved to you than your own self. Then Umar رضي الله عنه said to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and he didn't think a lot or didn't take a lot time to reply to the Prophet, and he said, الآن والله لا أنت أحب إلي من نفسي. Now by Allah, you are more beloved to me than my own self. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, as we know, said to Umar, الآن يا عمر, now you are a true believer, عمر. Now you have realized and the truth and have given the correct answer and statement. And to know the reason that we should love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam more than any body, even our own selves. Imam Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah said, وَأَمَّا السَّبَبْ فِي وُجُوبِ مَحَبَّتِهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَكْثَرَ مِنْ أَيِّ شَخْصٍ فَلِأَنَّ أَعْظَمَ الْخَيْرِ فِي الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةِ لَا يَحْصُلُ لَنَا إِلَّا عَلَى يَدِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ بِالْإِيمَانِ بِهِ وَاتِّبَاعِهِ. The reason why it's obligatory to love the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم more than any other person is what we cannot attain the greatest good in this life or in the hereafter except at the hand of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم by believing in him and following him. And he continues saying, وذلك أنه لا نجاة لأحد من عذاب الله ولا وصول له إلى رحمة الله إلا بواسطة الرسول بالإيمان به ومحبته وموالاته واتباعه وهو الذي ينجيه الله به من عذاب الدنيا والآخرة وهو الذي يوصله إلى خير الدنيا والآخرة. That is because no one can be saved from the punishment of Allah and the mercy of Allah cannot reach him except by means of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. By believing in him, loving him, being loyal to him, and following him. This is the means by which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save him from punishment in this life and in the hereafter. This is the means by which he will attain what is good in this world and the hereafter. And he said, فإنه فهو الذي يخرج الله به من الظلمات إلى النور لا طريق إلا هو وأما نفس الإنسان وأهله فلا يغنون عنه من الله شيئا. He is the one, the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, he is the one by means of whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bring people forth from darkness into light. And there is no other way to Allah. As for a person's self and family, they will not benefit him anything before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And in another hadith, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين. None of you will have faith or iman until he loves me more than his father, his children, and all mankind. And Imam Ibn Hajar mentions that the negation of faith here, none of you will have faith, refers to the negation of perfection of faith. So it would mean none of you will have perfect or complete faith until he loves me more than his father, his children, and all mankind. And to understand why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said this, just mention حتى أكون أحب إليه من والده وولده والناس أجمعين, his father, his children, and all mankind. We should know that the word love here in this hadith referring to optional love, الحب الاختياري. As the Imam al-Khattabi رحمه الله says, there are two types of love. الحب الطبيعي, الحب والحب الاختياري. A natural love and optional love. There is a natural love such as the love of a hungry person for food or a thirsty person for water. A natural love stems from our human nature, or in other words, the way we have been created. Most people love beauty, power, wealth, etc. So there is no reason for this kind of love. On the other hand, there is الحب الاختياري, the optional love, which is a result of choice based on reason, usually after reflection and understanding. There is love based on respect and appreciation, such as the love of a person for his father or his parents. So the Prophet Muhammad said, حتى أكون أحب إليه, first thing, more than his father. One reason to love a person, to love him out of respect or appreciation. And there is love based on mercy, which is the love of a father for his child. And this is the second part, وولدي, his children. And there is love based on friendship or fellowship, And this is the love between people in general. والناس أجمعين, all mankind, such as love between spouses or between those who share a common profession or scholar in the same field or between those who meet on a daily basis or have business together. So when we have all the reason to love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And another way or another point of view that we love a person because who benefit us or who prevent harm from afflicting us. And we can see that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam benefit us through Islam, so we believe in him, believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we can attain Jannah. And he protect us from the punishment of Allah and punishment of the hellfire. And when you love the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, one of the fruits you will taste the sweetness of Iman. And Sayyidina Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu narrated that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, thalathun man kunna fihi wajada halawat al-Iman. One who attained the following three things will taste the sweetness of faith. أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهم, وأن يحب المرء لا يحبه إلا لله, وأن يكره أن يعود في الكفر كما يكره أن يقذف في النار. To make Allah and His Messenger more beloved to Himself than anything else. To love a person for no other reason except for the sake of Allah. And to hate, to return to disbelief just as much as he would hate to be thrown into fire. And then you will have a company of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Jannah. And Anas ibn Malik radiallahu anhu said that a man came to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and asked him, Mata as-sa'a? When will the last hour come? He asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about Yawm al-Qiyamah, the day of judgment. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied, asking that person, وَمَاذَا أَعْدَدْتَ لَهَا? What have you done to prepare for it? And the man said, لا شيء غير أني أحب الله ورسوله. Nothing except the love I have for Allah and His Messenger. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him and gave him good news, أنت مع من أحبب. You will be on that day with those whom you love. And when the Sahaba, the companion of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, heard this answer, Anas ibn Malik said, فَمَا فَرِحْنَا بِشَيْءٍ بَعْدَ الْإِسْلَامِ كَفَرَحِنَا بِقَوْلِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ أَنْتَ مَعَ مَنْ أَحْبَبْتَ. We never rejoiced in anything after accepting Islam more than his word when he said, you will be with those whom you love. And he continued saying, فأنا أحب النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وأبا بكر وعمر وأرجو أن أكون معهم بحبي إياهم وإن لم أعمل بأعمالهم. I love the Prophet Abu Bakr and Umar, and I hope to be with them in Jannah due to my love for them, even if I didn't do the same amount of good deeds as they do. And we need to think about the saying of man when he said la shay, he didn't nothing. He meant that he didn't perform many optional acts of worship, because in another narration he said in response to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam question of what he had done to prepare for the last hour, ma a'dadtu laha kathira salatin أو صيام أو صدقة. I didn't prepare for it with many prayer, fasting or charity. So he had done the minimum of good deeds, which is the obligations. And and this what we at least should do to get the chance or to have the chance to be with the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Jannah, to do at least the obligations and add extra deeds, the optional deeds. And then we can say, as Anas ibn Malik رضي الله عنه said, فَنَحْنُ نُحِبُّ النَّبِيَّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ وَأَبَا بَكْرٍ
وعمر والصحابة أجمعين، ونرجو أن نكون معهم بحبنا إياهم وإن لم نعمل بأعمالهم. We all love the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, أبو بكر, عمر and all his companions, and we hope to be with them in Jannah due to our love for them, even if we didn't do the same amount of good deeds as they do. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, in the hadith, when Anas رضي الله عنه said, فما فرحنا بشيء بعد الإسلام كفرحنا بقول النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم أنت مع من أحببت. We never rejoiced at anything after accepting Islam more than his word when he said, you will be with those whom you love. This shows us how much the companion, the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم loved the Prophet Muhammad. And I would like to share some examples and stories about their love to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and keep the reality of this love and the evidence of our love to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to another khutbah inshallah. So first, Ali ibn Abi Talib radiyallahu anhu was asked, كيف كان حبكم للنبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, how was your love for the messenger of Allah to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, كان والله أحب إلينا من أموالنا وأولادنا وآبائنا وأمهاتنا ومن الماء البارد على الظمأ. He was by Allah more beloved to us than our wealth, our children, our fathers, our mothers, and from cold water at the time of extreme and severe thirst. And listen to this story and narration of a hadith. A woman from Al-Ansar lost her husband, father and brother in the day of Uhud, في غزوة أحد. فقدت أباها وزوجها وأخاها. When she was informed of this, she asked, ما فعل رسول الله? But what happened to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم? The people said, خيرا هو بحمد الله كما تحبين. حمد الله is as safe as you would wish him to be. And she said, أروني حتى أنظر إليه. Show him to me so that I can see for myself. So the people pointed him out. When she saw the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, said, كل مصيبة بعدك جلل يا رسول الله, كل مصيبة تهون وتصغر إلا مصيبتك يا رسول الله. Any disaster besides that of losing you is insignificant. And Aisha رضي الله عنها narrated that a man came to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and said to him, يا رسول الله, إنك لأحب إلي من نفسي وأهلي وولدي, وإني لأكون في البيت فأذكرك فما أصبر حتى آتي فأنظر إليك. O messenger of Allah, you are more beloved to me than myself, my family and children. Sometimes when I am at home, I remember you and I can't wait until I come and look at you. And he said, وإذا ذكرت موتي وموتك عرفت أنك إذا دخلت الجنة رفعت مع النبيين وأني إذا دخلت الجنة خشيت ألا أراك. When I think about my death and your death, I know that you will be with the Prophet when you enter Jannah, and I fear that I might not see you when I enter Jannah. The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم didn't answer him until the ayah was revealed to him, ومن يطع الله والرسول فأولئك مع الذين أنعم الله عليهم من النبيين. الآية. And whoever obeys Allah and the messenger, then they will be in the company of those on whom Allah has bestowed his grace of the prophets and all the good people. And in another narration is that Ansari man also came to the messenger of Allah while feeling sad, and the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said to him, يا فلان ما لي أراك محزونة, why do I see you sad? And the man said, messenger of Allah, I was thinking about something, شيء أفكر فيه. And the Prophet Muhammad said, ما هو? What is it? And the man said, نحن نغدو عليك ونروح, ننظر إلى وجهك ونجالسك, وغدا ترفع مع النبيين فلا نصل إليك. We come to you day and night, looking at your face and sitting by you. Tomorrow you will be raised with the Prophet, and we will not be able to see you. And the Prophet Muhammad didn't say anything, but later Jibreel came down to him with this ayah, and the Prophet Muhammad sent the good news to the Ansari man. فأرسل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم فبشره بهذا الأمر. So whoever wants to attain this grace of tasting the sweetness of faith, having the company of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم in Jannah, must love the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, follow his path and his sunnah, so that he may be with him in Jannah. Let us have a great love of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Let us study his life so that we can apply and follow his teaching and come closer to Allah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who truly follow the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, and may he forgive our sins.